If you're not aware, GTA 4 secretly had a way to load modified game files without actually replacing the game's original files. I've already done a video on this, but just to sum it up, if you created a folder called Update in your GTA 4 folder and added an IMG archive called update.img, any modified files you put into this IMG archive will be used over the game's original files, assuming the files you're modifying were in an IMG archive to begin with. So the modding community recently took advantage of this, and the result was Fusion OverLoader, a mod loader for GTA 4 that makes use of the update folder and makes it so you can load any type of game files, not just files located in IMG archives. This allows you to install mods with a simple drag and drop, without actually replacing game files, without needing additional tools, and without needing to make backups of your game files. It can be a bit confusing how it works, but I'm going to cover everything you need to know in this video. Just before we start, keep in mind, things in this video may change in the future, as Fusion OverLoader may get further developed and methods may change. Please check the description and pinned comment for any information on changes before watching. Anyway, let's get started. To use Fusion OverLoader, you need Ultimate ASI Loader, FusionFix, and you need to be using the complete edition of GTA 4. As of this video, FusionFix doesn't officially support older versions of the game, but this might change in the future. FusionFix is a community patch which fixes a lot of major issues with the PC version of GTA 4, and there's basically no reason not to use it. Ultimate ASI Loader is packaged with FusionFix, and is used to load ASI plugins. To install FusionFix, simply download the mod from the link in the description. Open the mod archive and then copy all of the files in the archive into your GTA 4 folder. That's it! Ultimate ASI Loader and FusionFix are installed. Both of these mods enable Fusion OverLoader to work. If we open the update folder, we can see FusionFix is already making use of Fusion OverLoader by loading some of the files for the mod in the update folder. Just for the sake of this video, I'm going to remove the files in my update folder to make it easier for you to follow along. You don't have to copy what I do in this video. Instead, just watch and listen, and you should get a good idea of how Fusion OverLoader works and how to use it. When installing mods using Fusion OverLoader, the installation method has to be done in one of two ways, depending on whether the modified game files were stored in IMG archives or outside of IMG archives. So it goes like this. Game files that were stored in IMG archives get installed one way using Fusion OverLoader, and files that were stored outside of IMG archives get installed another way using Fusion OverLoader. The first file type we'll cover how to install is files that were originally in IMG archives. So GTA 4, like its predecessors, stores the majority of the game's assets, such as texture archives and models, inside IMG archives. Previously, if a mod wanted to change these files, the author would usually package the modified files in a zip archive, and then tell the user to use Open4 to open one of the game's IMG archives, and replace the game's original files with the modified files from the mod inside the IMG archive. It's not very user-friendly, it's not great for beginners, and if something goes wrong, it can be a headache to fix. So, how does Fusion OverLoader handle this? Well, instead of having to mess around with Open4, replacing game files inside IMG archives, and making backups, Fusion OverLoader turns mod installation into a simple drag and drop. Let's take a look. I've just downloaded this remastered vehicle pack, which is packaged to support Fusion OverLoader. I'll link it in the description. To install this mod, all I have to do is open the mod archive and then drag and drop the mod folder into the update folder. And that's it, the mod is now installed. So this is the folder for the mod. This contains the mod's files. If we take a look at the mod files, we can see an IMG archive called ivvehiclepack2.0.img. This IMG archive contains remastered vehicle textures for all of the base GTA 4 vehicles. Before Fusion Overloader, all of these files would have needed to be placed into the game's own vehicle.img archive, where the game's original textures would be replaced upon doing so. But with Fusion Overloader, they can simply be placed into this archive and the game will now load these files instead of the original files located in vehicle.img. In the mod folder, we also have folders for The Lost and Damned and The Ballad of Gay Tony. Fusion Overloader recognizes these folders when they're named this way and will load IMG archives in these folders only for their respective DLC. So an IMG archive inside the Lost and Damned folder will only load when playing The Lost and Damned, and the same applies for the Ballad of Gay Tony folder. You can also create a folder simply called IV, and Fusion Overloader will only load any IMG archives in this folder when playing the base GTA 4 game. So it goes like this: IV and DLC specific folders inside a mod's folder will only load the IMG archives inside them when you play that specific game or DLC. IMG archives not placed inside one of these folders will load for the base game and both DLCs, such as the IV Vehicle Pack 2.0.img we see here. Another thing to keep note of, an IMG archive located outside of the IV and DLC folders can contain files for the base game as well as both DLCs. For example, the APC is only available in the Ballad of Gay Tony. If you put the texture archive for the APC inside IV Vehicle Pack 2.0.img, the texture archive will still load from this IMG archive when playing the Ballad of Gay Tony, despite not being in the folder for the Ballad of Gay Tony. For this mod, the IMG archives inside the DLC folders contain new textures for the vehicles exclusive to the respective DLC, mainly for organization, but all of the files could be merged into the IV Vehicle Pack 2.0 IMG archive and the mod would still work perfectly. IMG archives loaded with Fusion Overloader can contain any file that was originally in an IMG archive. That includes map models, map textures, weapons, vehicles, and so on. Any file that was originally in an IMG archive can be loaded through an IMG archive in the update folder. Fusion Overloader can load multiple different IMG archives per mod folder and the DLC subfolders too. So, if I wanted 5 IMG archives in this mod's folder, Fusion Overloader will load all of them and the files in them as well. Please keep in mind, you can't just place any file into an IMG archive in the update folder and expect it to work. The file has to have originally been in an IMG archive in the first place. The game is expecting these files to be in IMG archives, and that's the only way they'll get loaded. Here's an example of what the folder hierarchy looks like when installing these type of mods in Fusion Overloader. So what are you meant to do if two mods replace one of the same files, and you want to use one mod's file over the other? Fusion Overloader thankfully supports priorities. So how does this work? Let's say you have two mod folders in your update folder. One mod makes the license plates for all the vehicles green, but you have another mod which makes only the taxi license plate yellow. Both mods have IMG archives, which contain an edited taxi texture archive to achieve this. But how do we get Fusion Overloader to use the taxi texture from the yellow license plate mod over the green license plate mod, or maybe the other way around? Fusion Overloader loads IMG mods based on the name of the mod's folder, where 1 will overwrite 10 and A will overwrite Z. Numbers overwrite letters. So the best way to use this feature is to add numbers to the start of your mod folders. If I change taxi with yellow license plate to 1 taxi with yellow license plate, and then change green license plates to 2 green license plates, Fusion Overloader will give priority to any files in the 1 taxi with yellow license plate folder over the 2 green license plates folder, as the priority of that folder is less than the 1 taxi with yellow license plate folder. And if I do it the other way around, the green license plate mod will load instead. I think that's enough for IMG mods with Fusion Overloader. Just to note, all of the functionality we've covered is done through the ASI plugin which comes with FusionFix. Without this plugin, most of what we've just covered wouldn't work. In a few, we'll cover how to convert mods like this which don't support Fusion Overloader out of the box, to making them support Fusion Overloader. Okay, but what about files that aren't in IMG archives? Files that aren't in IMG archives work a bit differently with Fusion Overloader. Instead of being in a dedicated mod folder, files outside of IMG archives must mirror their original location in the update folder. For example, if you download a mod which contains a file such as timecyc.dat, typically the mod would tell you to replace the game's original timecyc.dat. This file controls the game's weather. So, to install, you'd go to the game's PC folder, then go to the data folder, and then replace the game's original file with the mods file. With Fusion Overloader, replacing the game's original files is no longer necessary. Instead, with Fusion Overloader, you just need to mirror your game's file structure. So, you'd go to your update folder, create a new folder called PC, then create a folder in that folder called data, and then you would place your modified timecyc.dat file into that data folder. This mirrors the game's original timecyc.dat location, except within your update folder. Fusion Overloader will now load the modified timecyc.dat within the mirrored folder over the game's original file. If a mod uses individual game files and supports Fusion Overloader, the files should come packaged so that they're just a drag and drop into your update folder instead of you needing to create all the mirrored folders yourself. FusionFix changes a lot of individual files and uses IMG archives. If you check your own update folder right now, you'll see several mirrored game folders which contain modified individual game files. You'll also see a folder which contains several FusionFix IMG archives, which changes some files which were originally located in the game's default IMG archives. The loading of mirrored files is done through Ultimate ASI Loader, which is the dinput8.dll file. Fun fact, the mirrored files feature works for all games that work with Ultimate ASI Loader. Just mirror the game's files within a folder called Update, and Ultimate ASI Loader will load those files over the original game files. This basically makes Ultimate ASI Loader a type of mod loader for a lot of games. So, what if you download a mod which isn't packaged with Fusion Overloader in mind? A lot of older GTA 4 mods will be like this, as Fusion Overloader is only a recent development. Well, if the file isn't from an IMG archive, you just need to mirror the modified file in your update folder. So again, for example, if you download a mod and it says replace weaponinfo.xml, which is located in the common/data folder, you'd go to your update folder, create a new folder called common, if it doesn't exist already, create another folder inside the common folder called data, and then place the mods file there instead. Fusion Overloader will load this file instead of the game's original file. What if the file is from an IMG archive? In this case, you'll need Open4 to create an IMG archive. I'll leave a link to Open4 in the description, and I'd recommend installing it if you plan on installing a few GTA 4 mods. Anyway, you download a mod which doesn't support Fusion Overloader, and the mod tells you to replace several files inside one of the game's IMG archives with the files from the mod. To install these files with Fusion Overloader, we'll need to make our own IMG archive. So open Open4, click Edit Mode, and then click Yes on the warning. Open your update folder, right-click in the folder, go to New, and then create a new folder for the mod. Name the folder whatever you want. preferably after the name of your mod. Next, open the mod folder you just created. Right-click anywhere in the folder, go to New, and then create a new GTA IMG archive. Name the archive whatever you want. Once done, open the archive in Open4 by double-clicking on it. Now all you have to do is extract the mod files to a folder anywhere on your PC. Then drag the mod files from the folder into your newly created IMG archive. That's it. The modified files will now load from the IMG archive inside Fusion Overloader. And that's basically everything covered for Fusion Overloader. Ideally, mods that come with Fusion Overloader support will always be a simple drag and drop. You won't need Open4 and you won't need to create folders that mirror the game's folders. The mod will be packaged with those folders already. Before Fusion Overloader, I made a video on the remastered vehicle pack I used as an example in this video. The installation in that video was a 9-step process. Since Fusion Overloader became a thing, installing that mod now only requires 2 steps. Anyway, thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, be sure to give it a like. If you like GTA modding videos, be sure to subscribe to the channel, and I'll catch you later.